Bwana Yesu wasifiwe. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is my belief and my trust that you are well kept of the Lord, and the Lord has continued to sustain you, even now that we are serving the Lord through this platform. It is our belief and our prayer that God is going to give us an opportunity that all of us at one point will gather in church once again. Do not worry, do not be dismayed that maybe because you have accommodation, maybe you have a small child, maybe because of age you are not able to attend our services. But let us trust with the Lord, let us continue trusting Him, let us continue praying that He's going to open more avenues for us, even through this platform that the word of the Lord is going to reach us. My name is Wilson. I'm born again. Christ is the Lord and my Savior. I thank the Lord for giving me a chance and a privilege to serve Him, even as an evangelist in this parish. And we thank the Lord because we are sure that He has an agenda and a purpose for all of us. You may be at home, you may be able to come to church, but do not be worried. Do not be worried. Focus unto Christ, and He is going to help us, and He is going to address our issues. He is going to lead us in all our situations, in all our circumstances. We will pray, and then we share the word of the Lord in a brief way. Father Lord, we thank you, we honor you, and we glorify you. Thank you, Jehovah Lord, even for our viewers. Thank you, even Jehovah Lord, for everyone who is going to get this word, Abba Father. Dear Lord, may you speak to their souls, may you speak to their minds, Abba Father. Speak to all of us, Abba Father. King of all the glory, you know our desires, you know our hearts, you know our challenges, you know our iniquities, dear King of all the glory. We pray that Jehovah Lord, out of your mercy and grace in abundance, O Lord, that you may speak to us in a great and a mighty way. In Jesus' name, do we pray and we give thanks.
Amen.
Today we are going to reflect about a story from the book of Luke, chapter number 22, from verses 54 to verses 62. This is a story of Peter, one of the best disciples that Jesus had. And we are talking of Peter who disowned Jesus, Peter who denied Jesus, after they had a very close walk, a very long walk with Jesus. And the Bible says, from verses 54, then seizing him, they led him and took him away into the house of the high priest. Peter followed him at a distance. But when they had kindled a fire in the middle ground of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat down with them. A servant girl saw him seated there in the firelight. She looked closely at him and said, this man was with him. But he denied it. Woman, I don't know him, he said. At a little later, someone else saw him and said, you are also one of them. Man, I am not, Peter replied. About an hour later, another asserted, certainly this fellow was with him, for he is a Galilean. Peter replied, man, I don't know what you are talking about. Just as he was speaking, the cock crowed. Then the Lord turned and looked straight at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word the Lord had spoken to him. Before the cock crows today, you will disown me three times. And he went outside and wept bitterly. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. When we talk and or reflect about the life of Peter, Peter was one of the very close friends of Jesus when Jesus was having his ministry here on earth. It is Peter that acknowledged who Jesus was. When Jesus asked the question, who do you think I am, or what do you think people say I am? What do you know about me? Peter knew and acknowledged and replied that you are Christ. So he understood who Jesus was. He had walked with him. Alikuwa amelewa Yesu ni nani. Number two, we are talking about Peter, who was a very close of a close friend of Jesus, that even during the transfiguration, him and other two of the disciples were present during the transfiguration of Jesus. Meaning that even Jesus trusted him, him had a close walk with Jesus, and they shared a lot. Again, it is the same Peter who walked on water. So he knew the power and the miracles and the ability of Jesus. Again, due to their friendship and the trust and the work they had together, it is the same Peter who took a sword to defend Jesus from being arrested. He didn't want him to go. And therefore, We are not talking of a Peter who was estranged from Jesus. He knew the man he was dealing with. But when Jesus got arrested, something funny or interesting took a new twist in the life of Peter. He feared, he got worried, that even the same Jesus that he had walked with had been arrested, and therefore he started walking at a distance. He started following Jesus at a distance. The bond that was there cracked. The bond that was there it was not very strong as it was before. And therefore, fear and cowardice crept in the life of Peter. And what happened next? He started to deny Jesus. He started to deny the ability of Jesus. He started to deny his walk with Jesus. Imagine he had walked for more than 3 years that Jesus was serving in his ministry. But now, because of one instance, when his walk and Jesus suffered a distance, Peter started following him and started disowning. He started to deny the presence or even the knowledge of Jesus, the same Jesus he had acknowledged as Christ. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That is the same thing that happens in our race, brothers and sisters. We are born again, but the moment our walk with Jesus starts having cracks, when we start following Jesus at a distance, for instance, right now, I know there are some of us who may have conditions, there are some of us who may have little children, and they may not be able to come to church because of the laws that and the regulations that have been put here by the government and the church. But there are others, just because of the few months that the church had been closed, their walk with Jesus, it developed cracks. And they started following Jesus at a distance. And now fear, excuses, lamentations are their thing. And what happens to them? Like Peter, when a servant girl came and pointed at Peter, Peter disowned, he denied the knowledge of Jesus. Alisema yeye hamjui. Another man comes and akamwambia, you are even a Galilean, wewe mlikuwa pamoja, wewe ni Galilean wewe. Peter denies and starts asking, who do you, what are you talking about? Mimi ni mtu sijui ni nani, hata sijui alitoka wapi. This is the very same thing that is happening to our lives today, brothers and sisters. That because of a small problem, a challenge that has come our way, just because biashara yako imeanguka tu kidogo tu, just because you've been able to pay rent for 1 month, you start disowning the power of Jesus. The same Jesus that had given you that business, the same Jesus that has given you that house, the same Jesus that gave you that employment, the same Jesus that gave you an opportunity to serve him, unaanza kumdeny because fear and cowardice imeanza kucreep into your life just because you are following him at a distance, just because umeanza kumfuata nyuma badala ya kutembea mko pamoja. Brothers and sisters, look at it this way. That is the same Jesus ambaye alikupatia hiyo biashara, alikupatia hiyo kazi. And at that time, he was a good God, he was a good father, he was a good Jesus, and he had the power to provide them. How comes now that because imeanguka kidogo, umeanza kufikiria Yesu hana uwezo wa kukusaidia. Umeanza kufikiria Yesu hana nguvu ya kukutoa penye huko. Katika hiyo shimo ambayo umeingia kwa sababu ya pandemic, kwa sababu ya corona. Why do you think that Jesus does not have the power to take you out of that problem? Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Fear, cowardice, doubt start creeping into us. That we start now following other people's views, we start going to wagangas, we start looking for help from men, and we deny our focus unto Jesus. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. We have the responsibility not to crucify Christ again. We who are born again, we who are believers, we who are in this faith, we have the power and the ability to ask Jesus to come down and help us. But what is happening to us, ndugu na dada? What is happening to us, wapendwa? Why are we allowing us fear? Why are we allowing us situations, circumstances, to deny us the privilege to believe in Jesus? Imagine Peter alishtukiwa na msichana wa kazi, a man ambaye alikuwa amechukua sword to defend Jesus. Msichana wa kazi anamshtua mpaka Peter na deny Yesu ni nani. Imagine your problem is not as big as you think. Your situation is not as deep as you think. Jesus has the ability. He has the power. Let us not deny him his power. Let us not deny him his authority in our lives. King, he is the King of Kings, he is the Lord of Lords. We have been given the power to trample on serpents and scorpions. Ametupatia mamlaka. But what are we doing? We are running away because of challenges, because of problems, and we deny him his ability to intervene in our situation. We are not exercising the power that we have. Probably nobody could have asked Peter any question anyway. Nobody could have arrested Peter. Just because he feared, he denied his master, he denied the power of Jesus even to save him, even if he was to be arrested. And that is why Jesus looked at him at his eye, and Peter remembers who Christ was. Wadugu na dada, let us remember who Christ is in our lives. Let us remember how he has saved us in the past. Mwenye alituokoa hiyo time, mwenye alikupatia hiyo biashara, mwenye alikupatia hiyo familia, mwenye alikupatia hiyo kazi, let us not deny him today. He is still the same God as he was, he will be, and he will always be the God that he has been helping unto us. Let us focus and believe in him. Let us pray. We thank you and bless you, dear Lord Jehovah. We have sinned for denying you. We have sinned for denying your ability to help us, Abba Father. We have belittled you, Jehovah Lord Father. We have failed to magnify you, O Lord. We pray, King of all the glory, forgive us, Abba Father. May you renew your mercies in our lives, Abba Father. May you renew our relationship with you, Abba Father. Even as we approach thy throne of mercy, O God, may we renew our covenant with you, dear King of all the glory, Abba Father. Accept us back into your fold, O God, that we may acknowledge your power and your authority in our lives, Abba Father. For when you are present with us, O God, we are sure, we are certain that our situations will not remain the same again. You are changing us and you are improving us day by day, Abba Father. Where our faith has fallen, where our faith is shrinking, the King of all the glory, may you strengthen us, King of all the glory. May you build us once again, Abba Father, that we may stop denying you, the Lord Jehovah, to the glory and to the honor of your name, Abba Father. In Jesus' name, do we pray and do we give thanks.
Amen.
Tubarikiwe sana.
Amen.